What's going on, YouTube? Megan here, and today I have a review, actually of the best skins ever, which is on my iPhone 5 right now. If you don't want a case on your phone, if you love the light, slim form factor of the iPhone 5, then this product is for you. I first really wanted to say thank you to Best Skins Ever for hooking me up with this product. I've worked with them in the past. I actually have a skin on my MacBook Air from them, and I love it. I will never take it off. And so I just want to, again, say thanks to the cool people there. Head over to Best Skins Ever and check out this product and other products. They have skins for all of your products. Basically, it's like you have nothing on your product, but it has full body protection, and so you know your device is protected, but you still get to keep that form factor and the nice look and feel of your product. So without further ado, let's get to the installation and review. Now, Best Skins Ever includes really simple packaging. It just basically comes in an envelope, which really does cut down on shipping costs. Inside, you get your invoice, just talking about the price and your address and all that. And then here's the skin itself. So it does have front, back, and side protection. And it does recommend not letting the sticky parts touch. Now, they don't include any solution. You have to mix your own. It's basically just a little bit of dish soap and then water in a spray bottle. So again, that also cuts down on cost. So I have an iClear travel wipe. You can use those to clean your device. I have a nice thick squeegee for installation, some more cleaners, and you'll need some microfibers and some tape, maybe to clean all the little bits of debris. So let me just clean this off and then we'll get to the installation of the skin. So I'm going to start with the installation of the back first. So I've got a microfiber cloth that I've sprayed with some cleaner, and you want to give your device a really good wipe down. Make sure that there's no fingerprints or dust and debris. So this is the method that I choose, but you can do whatever you want. And then I take a piece of tape just to pull up any little bits of dust that I maybe can't see, because you really don't want any dust under this, because once it's on, it's on. So then you take the skin, get it nice and wet, and lay it down. It is easy to move around. I just skipped all the installation part because it is quite tedious. But once all of the water is pushed out, and you're done. And the same thing goes for the front. You want to make sure your device is really clean. So I not only used a microfiber with some spray, but I also used a finer microfiber just to really polish it up and get all those fingerprints and dust off. And again, I took some tape and I pulled up any dust particles that might be on, because I don't like to have any bits under my screen. So have it nice and clean before you put the screen shield on. So I didn't do the full install on camera for you because, one, my head got in the way, and two, my camera died. So here it is on my phone. It has been on for a few weeks and I love it. So here's the cutout on the back around the camera, secondary mic and flash. Looks great, fits perfect. And the protection goes right up to the edge of the phone, so you have full back protection, and I think it looks great. Did a great install on the back, so it looks good. Now on the front, you have kind of an interesting cutout around the camera and the sensor and the earpiece. And then on the bottom, it's not totally all the way around the home button, which is annoying. I know Zag does this. Not sure why they're doing that and why it won't, you know, offer protection right around the whole home button. This kit that I bought was case friendly, and so it will work with cases that kind of come up over the edge, like sliders or maybe like spec candy shells and stuff, so it won't pull it up at all. Not a perfect install, a bit of hazing in there, but you can see kind of the orange peel effect a little bit. And then on the bottom, you've got one piece for the speaker, the connector, and the microphone. It is not a perfect install, so it is pulling up a bit. These little edges, also see around the microphone here, or the headset jack, is pulling up. Not really sure what to do about that, but one piece that goes up here to under the volume rocker, then a tiny piece in the middle here, which was very hard to get perfect, and then another piece that starts at the top of the volume rockers and wraps around to the other side of the sleep awake, and it's perfect around there, and then one piece that goes along this side, leaving an opening for the SIM card tray if you were wanting to pull that out. The side protection is nice, but I found it very hard to get cases on, and as you can see, those little pieces, unless they're perfect, they're going to pull up up, and for me they're kind of annoying and they didn't really fit with a lot of my cases. But if you want no case and you want full body protection, Best Skins Ever is probably what you want to choose. Doesn't get super fingerprinty, they're easy to wipe off. You can see it is a bit orange peely, but it provides some grip. So overall, I really love this skin from Best Skins Ever. I'll put links to their channel down below. If you haven't subscribed already, click up there, leave me a thumbs up if you like, and if you have any comments about this product, please leave them down below, and I will catch you guys all laters. Cheers.